Hey guys, welcome back to my channel. Today I wanted to film a makeup tutorial using no false eyelashes and also really chill, really natural looking makeup because sometimes we do have time to get ready, but we don't have enough time to do a full blown smoky eye or full on glam, but you still wanna look somewhat ready. So this is gonna be that kind of tutorial, a very natural makeup look. And I've really been into that lately. I think it's really pretty and it's suitable for just about everyone. I also included what I like to do as far as skincare before I apply my makeup. And I used a whole lot of drugstore products. So if you guys are interested in getting this natural looking makeup look, please keep watching and I will show you how. Okay guys, so first I'm going to be washing my face with my Origins Checks and Balances Foaming Face Wash. That's a mouthful, but this is an amazing face wash. It's super foamy and it really suds up on your skin. I feel like my skin has really improved since using this face wash. I got it as a Sephora perk and I think it was the 500 point perk. It comes with three other items in that little box and I've been using those and I feel like it's really cleared up my skin. I recently had a few little pimples and breakouts going on and this really cleared it up and so far I really, really love it and I'm looking forward to buying a big bottle of this once I run out of this little trial size. And if you like more of like a foamy face wash, you'll really like this one. And so far, I am just loving it. So next I'm gonna go in with my Neutrogena Hydro Boost Water Gel. There's two different kinds. There's a water gel and a water lotion. And I really like the gel because it dries really nicely and really quick on the skin. I use this every single morning with also that other face wash that I had used before. You just wanna make sure you rub this in so it's not super oily or anything on your skin because I am gonna start going in with makeup shortly after this routine. So next I'm gonna go in with some chapstick and this is just Carmex chapstick because later I will be wearing a liquid lipstick and I wanna make sure my lips are nice and moisturized before I do that. So next I'm gonna go in with my favorite primer lately and this is Revlon Photo Ready. I'm just going to apply this all over my face and I'm using a Sigma 3D HD Kabuki brush for this, which is really great for applying primer. It just really gets into all those crevices of your face. And I absolutely love this primer. I can't stress it enough, you guys. This is the best drugstore primer I have ever used. So next I'm gonna go in with my L'Oreal Infallible Pro Matte Foundation. This is an oldie but a goodie. This is in the shade 103 and I'm using an EcoTools bronzer brush, I believe. And this is really nice. It kind of reminds me of the Tarte foundation brush that everybody's been going crazy over. So if you're looking for another alternative other than buying that brush, which I think it's pretty expensive, this one is not expensive at all. I will leave the description and price of it in the description box. Next, I'm gonna go in with my Age Rewind Concealer. And I used to use this all the time. I totally forgot how pigmented this concealer is. It's more of on the thicker coverage side, but I think it's really nice. And I'm gonna start using this a lot more. This has way more coverage than the Urban Decay Naked Skin Concealer and I really love that concealer as well, but this is very comparable and it's really, really great when it comes to pigment. So if you're looking for a new concealer, I would definitely suggest getting this one. I'm just tapping this out with a Real Techniques sponge and I'm bringing that concealer also onto my eyelids. This is just going to even out my skin tone and make sure my eyelids are primed for a little bit of eyeshadow I will be applying later on in this video. Next, I'm going to go in with my Anastasia Banana Powder and my MAC Emphasize Powder, and I'm just going to apply this under my eyes and also on my eyelids, and then with that excess powder, I'm just gonna go around my face and just set my foundation a little bit. I don't want this to be too cakey. Next, I'm gonna go in with my Milani Bronzer, and this is a really, really nice, natural-looking bronzer. It kind of has a little bit of glitter in it, so make sure that you definitely diffuse this out with your brush. Next, I'm gonna go in with my Milani blush, and this is in Berry Amour. This is definitely my favorite drugstore blush going on right now. I love all the Milani blushes, but this one is so far my favorite color. It's a really nice pinky warm tone. Next, I'm gonna go in with my Becca Champagne Glow Palette, and I couldn't really find a highlighter I really liked from the drugstore, so if you guys have any suggestions for me, please comment below. I would love to try something new, but so far, I am loving this Champagne Glow Palette. Next, I'm gonna fill in my eyebrows, and I always use my Anastasia Dip Brow. And then I'm gonna go in with my Brow Stylist Plumper, and this is in medium to dark. I just kinda like to fill it in wherever it looks a little sparse, and I go in the direction of where my brow hairs grow, so the front grows a little more upward, and then towards the tail end of the brow, it kinda grows downward. So I just follow the angle and hair growth of my eyebrows. Next, I'm gonna go in with Makeup Geek Creme Brulee, and I'm going to apply this to my crease. I'm not using a lot of this at all. Actually, when I dip the brush into Creme Brulee, I tap it off quite a bit, so it's a very diffused light brown shade. This is just really gonna deepen up your eye sockets, and it's very natural. This doesn't have glitter in it. It is a matte shade, so any really light brown matte shade will work. If you have one that you really love, then go ahead and use that one. I am just diffusing this into my crease in windshield wiper motions. Next, I'm gonna go in with MAC Shroom, and I've had this eyeshadow for a long time. It's a really nice, white, creamy, shimmery shade. I'm applying this into the tear duct and also all over the lid. I'm gonna take a fluffy brush and blend that all out. I'm gonna take some more of that color Shroom, and I'm applying this to my brow bone. This is really gonna make everything pop. It's gonna lift the brows up, and make sure with your brush you kind of drag this color down a little bit. You want it to blend really nicely. You don't want it to look like a streak of highlight. You want this to be really diffused and really subtle. Next, I'm just going to curl my lashes. Make sure you curl your lashes before mascara and not after, because you can rip your eyelashes off, so definitely do it before. I'm gonna go in with my CoverGirl Super Size Lash Mascara, my favorite mascara right now. I can't get over how amazing this mascara is. You guys really, really need to try it. It's my favorite. Next, I'm gonna go in with my L'Oreal Telescopic, my favorite for bottom lashes. This really separates your lashes really nicely. You can skip this step if you're not into the bottom lash mascara, but I am, and I really think it makes your eyes look a lot bigger when you apply it. Next, I'm gonna go in with this cream liner, and I'm applying this to my waterline. This is by Milani. This is like a vanilla shade, and this really makes your eyes look a lot bigger. So if you're trying to make your eyes look bigger, use a lighter shade. If you want them to look a little bit more smoky, then use like a black. But for this, I'm gonna use a vanilla shade. Next, I'm applying some of that pearl highlighter in my tear duct because I felt like the MAC Shroom wasn't as bright as I wanted it to be, so I just went back in with that. Next, I'm gonna go in with my Milani Color Statement Lip Liner in Spice. This is very comparable to MAC Spice, so if you're looking for somewhat of a dupe, I would try this one. This one really reminds me a lot of MAC Spice. Next, I'm gonna go in with my Revlon Ultra HD Liquid Lipstick, and these are very new. I just picked this up at my local Target about 3 days ago, and I would say it's not super matte. It does have a little bit of shine to it, so I don't know if I would really say this is a liquid lipstick. I didn't want to keep it super matte, so I do apply a gloss later on, but I really love the color selection that they have, and I would definitely pick this up. I think it's worth a buy as far as liquid lipsticks. So I'm gonna go in with my NYX Butter Gloss, and I will link what the name of this is. I'm not really sure, but I think this is a beautiful pink gloss, and it looks really nice over this lip color. I didn't want it to be super matte. So next, I'm going to be setting my face, and I like to keep my setting spray in this MAC Fix Plus bottle because I use the Nivea Refreshing Toner. This is a really nice dupe for Fix Plus, so I'm just gonna go ahead and set my entire face with a couple sprays of that. All right, guys, that is it for this video. I will see you in my next video, and thank you for watching. Alright guys, thank you so much for watching my tutorial. I really hope you enjoyed this natural, easy look, and I hope you can use it often. So thank you so much for watching, and comment below if you have any ideas for my next tutorial.